Hey, Out Late But Great, this is Jim here from Ohio, and it is Friday, and I am your host on Fridays on the channel Out Late But Great. So Jim from Atlanta picked the topic of the week, and it is, name a book that you are reading or have read that was very important to you. It doesn't have to be LGBT, it could be any book. Well, I decided to choose a book that I have talked about on this channel before, years ago. The reason I chose this book is because I actually reread it just a couple weeks ago, and I hadn't read it for 25 years, but it really made a big difference to me dealing with coming out of the closet when I was in my 20s. So the name of the book is Behind the Mask, and is by a guy named Dave Pallone. Here's the book, and that's Dave. And it's the story of an umpire here in the United States in the National League for baseball that was gay and came out of the closet and was actually fired for being gay, which sounds kind of absurd, but it's still legal in the United States, in most states, to fire somebody for being gay or deny them housing or whatever. So it's really a good insight into what he had to deal with in the macho world of baseball. It goes through his life. He grew up in Massachusetts, and he loved baseball, loved it. So this was his dream job. It really was. And it talks about him, you know, dealing with being in the closet and struggling and trying to fit in and trying to put the feelings that he had inside away, and it didn't work. He actually was engaged to be married once, but then broke it off because he just couldn't go through with it. It really, really is good, there's one part that's so funny in here, I wanted to read it to you. This is about him. One day he had a straight roommate, and they would go out to bars. And this was a conversation. The straight roommate's name was Jim. This is a conversation that he had with him. We'd go to the bar, and he'd say, "Maybe we'll get lucky tonight." And I'd say half-heartedly, "Maybe we will." But I had something else in mind. While he was sizing up the waitress with the nice legs, I was sneaking glances at the handsome bartender with the great smile. Of course, I would never tell Jim that. In most male bonding situations, the standard subjects were probably sports and screwing girls. In professional baseball, those subjects aren't just standard. They're almost automatic, which I'm sure is true. So yeah, I mean, if you get a chance, it's really, really a good book. It is. It sums up pretty much all the feelings that you have when you're trying to live in a closet, and again, when you finally let go, how different you feel, how much better you feel. So check it out. If you like I said, if you haven't heard it, I'm pretty sure it's on Amazon. So yeah, give it a shot. So anyway, gosh, it actually is kind of chilly here right now. It's been so warm this winter, and I think we might get a few snowflakes today. So I'm kind of looking forward to seeing a little bit of it because we haven't had any. And I think Christmas, they're saying it is supposed to be the warmest Christmas we've ever had on record. So it's such a strange year weather-wise. So anyway, guys, that's all I got to say. Take care, love you, and I will talk to you next week. Bye-bye.